I want to thank the Mill Valley Film Festival for everything you guys do, for figuring out a way to make it work during COVID, and supporting the arts and just being an awesome festival. And I'm so honored and humbled the other people who have played here in the previous years. I feel like I'm with really good company, and I appreciate it.
The thing that attracted me to this movie was, at first, was the writing. And then the director, Fabio, sent me a scissor reel of his, some shorts and some pieces that he shot. And there was so much energy in the scissor reel. And I go, wow, these guys can really shoot. And then the script was really moving and touching. So that's what really attracted me to it.
It started off just on a whim. Me and the lead actor, we both had other big projects that we thought were going to be our big breaks fall apart on us. And we just met up one day. We hadn't seen each other in probably like 8 months, just on a whim. And on the way to his new, like touring his new apartment, I just was joking around about, he was talking about how his landlord was kind of a weirdo. And I was talking about how it always seems like landlords are like the least qualified people to be landlords. And then he kind of opened up to me that he almost ended up becoming a landlord because his dad in Peru owns some apartments and had lung cancer and called him up. And he hadn't spoken to his dad in years. And so we just borrowed a lot from real life and then flushed out the rest, you know? So it's kind of like based on our real lives.
I love the story because I've never seen this story before told from a male perspective about divorce and the after effects of it, and how in some cases where it can really hurt the maturity of a young male, and how when his mother is not completely honest about what really happened. It happens a lot, but you never see that. It comes from the heart. Yeah, and you really feel that from the crew, the director, and from Pedro and Fabio, who wrote the film and what they were trying to say, and you wanting to be a part of that story.
This whole project has been basically us trying to do things a pay grade above what you should probably do on your first feature. And one of that was trying to work with actors who we really respected and looked up to. And we thought it was a long shot, but, you know, they read the script, some of them, and they really liked it. So it's awesome because, you know, normally like a first feature will just have other unknown actors. And to have people like Raymond and Stephen Bauer, you know, like give us the green light and, be a part of the project was just like so humbling and awesome. We hired an editor, but it didn't turn out quite the way I wanted. So me and the lead actor had to edit it ourselves for the last three, four months. Yeah.
It's a lot different. It's a faster pace. You don't have a lot of time. You know, you have to work quickly. And the thing is, there's not a lot of luxuries like on a big set, and there's not a lot of waiting really, because you're trying so to get everything done so fast. And then, but you know, your responsibility is the same as an actor. You have to show up prepared. You have to be ready to go. And you know, and you really have to approach these types of films with a lot of passion for them, because they demand a lot of you without giving you a lot back. You know, at first. And I'm talking like monetarily. You're not getting paid a lot to do it. You have to really be in love with the project, which it really was a passion project for me.
I'm feeling good. Honestly, at this point, I'm ready to give it away back to the public. I've been living with it for so long, you know, and I've probably watched this movie like over 50 times, you know, just doing like quality control checks, because we don't have a big, you know, budget to pay someone to do that. So I'm ready to give it away, you know.
The Mill Valley Film Festival was a great opportunity to showcase our movie and to get a great feel for the audience reaction to it. We were at the Woodstock Festival, and now we're so fortunate to come here and to have on the West Coast at the Mill Valley, which is going to be like a great moment to just see what the audience feels and get that synergy.
It's awesome. I just drove all the way across the country in my RV, like 12-hour days from New York to get here on time. So it's pretty cool. It's the first festival I've been to where I actually got in today. So I haven't had any time to like have like the nerves or anything else settle in. It's awesome. I think I'll do it like this in the future.